From the Rubaiyat of Umm Khayyam by Edmund Fitzgerald. As under cover of departing day slunk hunger-stricken Ramazan away, once more within the potter's house alone I stood surrounded by the shapes of clay. Shapes of all sorts and sizes, great and small, that stood along the floor and by the wall, and some loquacious vessels were, and some listened perhaps, but never talked at all. Said one among them, "Surely not in vain my substance of the common earth was ta'en, and to this figure moulded to be broke or trampled back to shapeless earth again." Then said a second, "Ne'er a peevish boy would break the bowl from which he drank in joy, and he that hath with his hand the vessel made would surely not in after wrath destroy." After a momentary silence spake some vessel of a more ungainly make, "They sneer at me for leaning all awry. What, did the hand then of the potter shake?" Whereat some one of the loquacious lot, I think a Sufi pipkin, waxing hot, "All this of pot and potter, tell me then, who is the potter, pray, and who the pot?" "Why," said another, "some there are who tell of one who threatens he will toss to hell the luckless pots he marred in making. Pish, he's a good fellow, and 'twill all be well." "Well," murmured one, "let whoso make or buy, my clay with long oblivion is gone dry, but fill me with that old familiar juice, methinks I might recover by and by." So while the vessels one by one were speaking, the little moon looked in that they were seeking, and then they jogged each other, "Brother, brother, now for the porter's shoulder knot a-creaking.